What's happening? In this video, I'm going to show you how you can lose fat and build muscle at the same time. Now, before the video starts, I'd just like to say, I'm not saying that losing fat while building muscle is the optimal way to do it. I'm also not saying that you're going to be able to build as much muscle in a deficit as you would in a surplus. All I'm saying is, if you want to lose fat while building muscle, you can do it, even though some people say you can't. And I'm going to show you how to do it. Right, so before we jump into losing fat while building muscle, I hate saying this, I really do. It feels so cringy, but I would really appreciate it if you hit subscribe, because we're on the road to 1,000, hopefully going to get there in the next couple of months. Just whack the subscribe button and be a legend. Right, so in the video, I'm going to cover nutrition, training, sleep, rest, recovery. Rest and recovery, that's the same thing, isn't it? Yeah. Supplements and basically everything you need to know to lose fat while building muscle. Your life's going to be a lot easier if you're a beginner and you don't actually need to pinpoint everything that I cover in this video and get it down to a T, because you're going to have this thing called newbie gains, and it's just pretty easy to lose fat while building muscle at the start of your journey. But as you go further into your journey and you're a few years into lifting, you're going to need to get everything basically pinpointed, and I'm going to cover everything that you need to do in order to optimize the process and lose fat while building muscle. So let's go. Firstly, let's talk about nutrition, because I think everyone knows that in order to lose fat you need eating a calorie deficit, and people often associate gaining muscle with eating in a calorie surplus, and for the most part, most people, that's the way you should do it. However, if you want to lose fat while building muscle, you need to be in a deficit, because you can build muscle in a deficit but you can't lose fat in a surplus. So you need to be in a deficit to lose fat and build muscle at the same time, but the way in which you create that deficit needs to be a bit more meticulous, if that's even the right word. Is meticulous the right word? I don't know, but you need to have it a bit more dialed down in order to be able to build muscle while you're in a deficit. So when you're just trying to lose fat, I would usually recommend eating in about a 300 to 600 calorie deficit. That's 300 to 600 below your maintenance, and losing up to about a kilogram a week. However, when you're trying to lose fat while building muscle, you want the deficit to be slightly smaller, only about 200 to 300 maximum in a deficit, and you only want to be losing about half a kilogram maximum per week. This is because if you're losing any more than that, your body's going to have a really hard time holding on to muscle that it even has, and it's not going to be able to build more muscle while you're in a deficit if the deficit is above 300. So as well as only eating in a slight calorie deficit, you want your protein to be high. Now, when you're losing fat, I only recommend eating about 2 grams of protein per kilogram body weight, because studies show that anything over about 2.2 per kg of body weight isn't really having any added benefit. Now, this is just my own personal prerogative. I don't even know if prerogative is a word either, but my own personal opinion, let's say that I would eat even up to 2.5 to 3 grams of protein per kilogram of body weight when you're trying to lose fat while building muscle, because the extra protein is just like, I don't know, there's no studies to show it, but in my personal opinion, if you're trying to lose fat while building muscle, having more protein is obviously going to be better. Now, you don't want to sacrifice your fats for this, because you need to have a minimum amount of fat to survive. So as long as you're getting up at least 0.6 grams of fat per kg of body weight and you're getting your carbs in too for energy, then you can afford to have up to 3 grams of protein per kilogram of body weight of protein and you're sweet. To sum up nutrition, only eat in a 200 to 300 calorie deficit, eat between 2.5 and 3 grams of protein per kg of body weight, and as well as that, I would actually recommend trying to prioritize whole foods, fruit and veg over junk food, because when your goal is just to lose fat, you can afford to have a bit more junk food, but in my opinion, prioritizing fruit and veg and only having a small allowance for junk food is just going to help you optimize your results. Now, I'm not saying don't eat any junk food, because I wouldn't really be practicing what I preach here, because I'm a big fan of junk food at the weekends and stuff, but all I'm saying is if you want to actually optimize building muscle while losing fat, which is why you're watching this video, I would try and prioritize. Instead of, I usually go for like an 80-20 rule when you're losing fat, maybe go more like a 90-10 and you're just going to get better results. Right, so now that's training covered. No, that's not training covered. So that now that's nutrition covered, let's talk about training. Why did that come out so awkwardly? I don't even care. Right, let's talk about training. Right, so how do you train if you want to lose fat while building muscle? Now, for most people, if they're just looking to either lose fat or build muscle, I'd say train a minimum of 2 or 3 times a week. But if you're looking to do both at the same time, I'd say a minimum of 4, a maximum of 6, and my sweet spot would actually be 5 sessions a week, going for a push-pull legs upper-lower split. Now, I'm not going to go into splits and how to program and all, because I have a full video on that, so if you want to watch that, you can watch it. But all I will say is a training a minimum of 4 times a week. Apply and progressive overload your training. Like, you need to be giving your muscles reason to grow, otherwise they're just not going to grow, whether you're in a deficit or a surplus. So especially when you're trying to lose fat while building muscle, progressive overload is so important. Make sure you're always adding more sets, more reps, more weight, or more time under tension. Just make sure you're doing more than before, otherwise you're never going to grow. As well as progressive overload, there's basically three mechanisms of muscle development, and if you want to lose fat while building muscle, I would recommend including all three of these mechanisms in each session. Now these are mechanical tension, muscle damage, and metabolic stress. I have discussed these in my how to build your own workout plan video, so if you want them in more detail, check out there. But all I'll say here is mechanical tension is lifting heavy things through a full range of motion. Muscle damage is when you lift things and it's in the concentric and the eccentric phase of the movement, so when you're doing like slow negatives and stuff. And metabolic stress is basically the pump. So if you can incorporate all three of them things in your workout, you're going to maximize muscle development, and it's really going to help you lose fat and build muscle at the same time. Right, so to put into practice and give you an example how I would structure a workout using all three mechanisms of these muscle development, let's say for example you're doing a push workout. So to start off, you might do bench press and overhead press. That's your mechanical tension. Then you might go into incline dumbbell press with a slow negative for your muscle damage. And then you might do a few other exercises in between, and you'd finish on a tricep drop set for your metabolic stress. That's just a quick example how you would include all three mechanisms of muscle development in one session. Right, so now that's training and nutrition covered, I want to talk about rest and recovery, because here's a fun fact for you. Your muscles don't actually grow when you're in the gym. You just damage your muscles in the gym, and then when you're resting, that's when your body has an opportunity to repair them and make them bigger. So if you don't give your body adequate time to rest and recover, and you just keep hammering the same muscle group, you're not actually going to be able to grow, and you're just fucking yourself over. As a general rule, I would say leave 48 hours rest in between training the same muscle group, so you give your body adequate time to repair and grow the muscles. However, this is going to vary greatly from person to person, depending on your work capacity or how much volume and training you can recover from. So if you've waited 48 hours rest in between, waited 48 hours rest, that doesn't even make sense. If you've waited 48 hours in between training the same muscle group and your muscles still feel too sore to go again, then don't go again. Listen to your body. The 48 hours is just like a ballpark estimate what you should wait in between training the same muscle group. Right, so intertwined into rest and recovery is your sleep. If you're not getting 7 to 9 hours sleep each night, you're not going to maximize muscle development. So many people try all these weird and wonderful things, supplements, training splits, all this stuff, in order to maximize muscle development, but they just completely overlook sleep. Like, you'll have people taking all these different supplements, BCAAs, EMAs, ZMA, whatever the A's in the fucking world, and they're literally getting like 4 hours sleep each night, and you're like, what are you doing, you absolute hater? Someone once said that if you could sell 7 to 9 hours sleep in a tablet form, it would be like the most useful supplement ever. So please get 7 to 9 hours sleep if you want to maximize muscle development, because your muscles grow while you're sleeping. So last and certainly least, because it is definitely the least important thing in terms of building muscle while losing fat, is supplements. Like, so many people over obsess over supplements, and most of the time it's because fitness YouTubers have shoved supplements down their throat, BCAAs and stuff like that, give them a discount code so they can make lots of money off them. And loads of people just think that you need all these weird and wonderful supplements in order to maximize your results, when in actual fact you don't. So here's 4 supplements that I'll give you that actually work. Protein, it's nothing special, it just helps you hit your protein goals, and it tastes rather nice. Creatine is going to help you with muscle development, it's going to help you with energy, ATP production. I have a full video on creatine if you want to watch it. It's also going to trap water weight in your muscles, so it's going to help you look bigger and stronger. That's the only 2 I'd really recommend for muscle development. And then in terms of general health, vitamin D if you don't get enough sun, and omega 3 if you don't get enough from your diet alone. And that is all I'm going to say about supplements, because they're really not that important. So I hope you enjoyed that video, I hope you actually learned something, and now you know how to build fat. No, why do I keep saying that? Now you know how to lose fat while building muscle, and hopefully you can go off and do it if that's what you want to do. Obviously, if you want to cut and bulk, it's probably a more optimal way to do it, but I just thought I'd make this video because I personally have lost fat while building muscle, and it feels pretty good. It's a pretty cool thing to do, so I want to show other people how you can do it as well. So if you learned something, I would appreciate it if you hit the like button, maybe drop the comment, and if you're not already subscribed, what are you waiting for? I'm going to be posting weekly videos. Hopefully they're actually going to be good. They might be, they might not. You'll have to find out. So I'll see you next week.